Hello everyone, welcome to my channel, Kim Insider. In the previous video, we discussed about the standard electrode potentials of or standard reduction potentials of metals in their oxidized and the reduced form. And further, we discussed the important topic of Nernst equation, where if you have to calculate the electrode potential of a cell whose concentration is not unity, then you can use that respective Nernst equation in order to find out the respective electrode potential of the cell, or you can also solve the EMF of the cell. So for that particular equation, we regard the equation as E of cell is equal to standard electrode potential of the cell, that is of E standard potential of cathode minus standard electrode potential of anode, that is nothing but the standard electrode potential of the cell, minus RT by NF ln of RT by NF ln of Zn2 plus concentration divided by Cu2 plus concentration. So this was the equation which we had derived. If you consider for a Daniell cell, what happens is, where we observe a zinc metal electrode dipped in zinc sulfate solution which is connected to copper electrode through a voltmeter. Okay. So now what we observe in this reaction is, the zinc metal present on the metal strip will be getting dissolved in the zinc sulfate solution, whereas the Cu2 plus ion present in the solution will be accumulated on the metal strip. So where we observe electron flowing from left to right, therefore current will be flowing from right to left. So if we consider for a voltmeter which is present at this position, it will be denoting certain volt of the cell, that is nothing but the 1.1 volt in case of Daniell cell. That is what we know. Now what happens is, as the reaction proceeds, what happens is, the concentration of the zinc sulfate, the concentration of zinc in zinc sulfate increases. That is because if you say a certain concentration of zinc sulfate is already taken in the zinc sulfate term, after a certain amount of reaction, what happens is, the zinc present on the metal electrode also get dissolved in the zinc sulfate solution. Therefore, concentration of zinc in zinc sulfate increases. In the same time, what happens is, the Cu2 plus present in the solution gets accumulated on the metal electrode of copper, that is a cathode copper. Therefore, concentration of Cu2 plus in the reaction decreases. So clearly what we can see is, the electrode potential which was observed initially will not be same throughout the reaction, right? Once the concentration varies, there will be variation in electrode potential of the cell also. The reading which was shown 1.1 volts at some point of time will be showing a zero. It will be going on decreasing for a certain period of time. And that at some time, what happens is, the reading of the voltmeter which is present interconnected to the cathode and anode electrodes will be reading a value of zero at some point of time. That particular point of time is called the equilibrium position of the particular Daniell cell. When the cell potential of a Daniell cell becomes zero in the voltmeter, then we can say that the particular Daniell cell has obtained equilibrium. Now, if you consider for that particular time of matter, we can say that E cell at that particular point of time will be equal to zero, right? E cell at equilibrium will be equal to zero. So now, if you consider the condition in order to find out the equilibrium constant of a Daniell cell, we can take this equation 1 as E cell is equal to zero, which is equal to E naught of cell minus. Now, what I am going to do is, instead of taking ln, I am going to take log. That means we have to multiply this variable with the number of 2.303. So that is minus 2.303 RT by, the value of N is 2, into F, log of concentration of Zn2 plus divided by concentration of Cu2 plus. So this is the equation which we obtain at equilibrium. Now, Since 2.303 is a constant, R is constant at a particular 298 temperature. So let us consider 298 Kelvin. We are considering this particular reaction. Now R is constant, that is 8.314. T is constant, that is 298 Kelvin. Faraday is a constant, that is 96,500. So on substituting those values, on calculating and taking this E naught cell on the left hand side, so we get E naught of cell is equal to, so this complete term will be coming on the other side, that becomes it positive. So that will be 2.303 R T by 2 into F log of Zn2 plus concentration divided by Cu2 plus concentration. Now what we know is 2.303 into 8.314 into 298 divided by 96,500. That is nothing but 2.303 RTF. So this value is 0.059. Taking that value over here, we'll just keep these two as it is. We don't need to vary, because if you are considering for a general reaction, that will be n. Therefore, E naught of this cell will be equal to 0.059 divided by n into log of concentration of Zn2 plus divided by concentration of Cu2 plus. Let it be equation 2. Now, at equilibrium, equilibrium constant Kc, equilibrium constant Kc will be equal to the concentration of Zn2 plus divided by concentration of Cu2 plus. Equilibrium constant will be equal to the concentration of Zn2 plus divided by concentration of Cu2 plus. So substituting that value over here, we get E naught of cell is equal to 0.059, where n is 2, into log of Kc. Okay, so this is for the E naught of the cell and the equilibrium constant of Daniell cell. But if you have to consider, this equation is for standard electrode potential and equilibrium constant relation of Daniell cell. But you have to consider for a general reaction, then the equation can be written as E naught of cell is equal to 2.303 RT by NF log of Kc. So this will be the general relation of equilibrium constant of a cell with the electrode potential. Okay, EMF, standard electrode potential of a cell, relations with equilibrium constant of the cell. So this will be the equation. Okay, so what happens is, when you consider for the equilibrium constant of a reaction in this particular Daniell cell, what we observe is, once the reaction starts to occur, the zinc metal present on the metal strip get dissolved in the solution, which increases the Zn2 plus ion concentration. Meanwhile, the Cu2 plus, which is deposited on the metal electrode, resulting in the decrease in the Cu2 plus concentration on the CuSO4 solution. So once the concentration is going to decrease, we are going to observe the decrease in value of voltmeter. So at a particular point of time, the voltmeter will be showing a value 0. If the cell has a voltmeter value showing 0, that means we can say that the particular cell has obtained equilibrium. So if you consider the cell potential E cell is equal to 0 at equilibrium, then the equation of 1, which is taken over here, can be written as E naught of cell is equal to 2.303 RT by 2 into F log of Zn2 plus by Cu2 plus. Substituting the value of 2.303 RT, F, etc. So we will get 0.059, where 2 is nothing but the number of electrons, that is 2 electrons are involved in this reaction. At equilibrium, equilibrium constant Kc will be equal to concentration of reactant by concentration of product. So concentration of reactor 1 by Cu2 plus divided by 1 by Zn2 plus can be taken as Zn2 plus by Cu2 plus. So that is what we are going to obtain. So substituting that equation, we get Daniell cell electrode potential is related to the equilibrium constant of Daniell cell. If you are considering for a general reaction, then E naught of cell will be equal to 2.303 RT by NF log of KC. Or you can also write E naught of cell is equal to RT by NF ln of KC. You can also take this also as an equation for equilibrium constant of a reaction of a cell with the electrode potential EMF of that particular cell. So this is the expression for equilibrium constant of a cell. This is for Daniell cell and this is for all other examples of different cells. Now next is, how can you relate electrode potential of a cell by their respective Gibbs energy? So we know that we create chemical energy, we make chemical energy converted to electrical energy. Now whenever you consider a cell which has been constructed by a chemical reaction to create certain amount of electrical current, what we can say is there is said to be some amount of work is done. So the electrical work done in that particular reaction is equal to the product of charge which is passed through the cell and the electrode potential of the cell. Therefore, let us consider the equilibrium constant and electrode potential which is related to the Gibbs free energy. Now, a Gibbs free energy equation can be given by the formula, that is nothing but product of total charge passed in the particular cell at 1 second in the given meanwhile time of having an electrode potential. Now, Gibbs free energy calculation. Gibbs energy. So, the relation between Gibbs energy and electrode potential or equilibrium constant of a given cell. Now, what I said is, Gibbs free energy, that is energy work done, energy or electrical work done, EW, electrical work done EW will be equal to potential of the cell into total charge passed through the cell in 1 second. Okay. So, potential of the cell is given by E cell, right? Potential of the cell is given by E cell and total charge passed through the cell is given by number of electrons into charge of 1 electron. So, therefore, the product of these two is equal to NF E cell. So, electrical work done is equal to total charge passed. The total charge passed is nothing but number of electrons into charge of 1 electron. That is a Faraday's constant. Next is for the multiplied by electrode potential for 1 second. So, this will be the electrical work done. Now, if we have to obtain maximum electrical work done, that means the Gibbs free energy should be in a reverse direction. If you have to obtain a maximum work done by a given cell, then the Gibbs free energy for that particular cell should be in a reverse direction. Therefore, if you calculate for the change in Gibbs free energy in a reversible reaction, that is delta G of R, that can be written as minus NF E cell. Minus NF E cell. Now, at equilibrium, what we can say is equilibrium E cell will be 0. Therefore, delta G of equation will be 0. Now, if you consider for delta G naught at equilibrium, then we can take the equation as minus NF E naught of the cell, where E naught of the cell is nothing but the standard cell potential. Okay, standard cell potential of the given cell. Now, since we know from the previous equation, E naught is equal to RT by NF ln KC, right? At equilibrium, E naught is equal to RT by NF into ln KC. Substitute that value over here. So, we get delta G naught of R, which is equal to minus NF into RT by NF ln Kc, Nf, Nf get cancelled. Delta G naught of R is equal to Rt ln Kc. Now, if you carefully observe over here, the Gibbs free energy of a cell depends upon the number of electrons. If more the number of electrons, lesser and lesser will be the Gibbs free energy. So clearly what we can say is, the E cell, that is the electrode potential of a cell, is an extensive particle, it has an extensive property, whereas delta G of Gibbs free energy has an intensive property, which means it depends upon the number of electrons present. But in this case, it does not clearly depend upon the electrons. Therefore, E cell is an extensive property, whereas delta G is an intensive property. Further, if you consider for the Gibbs free energy, standard Gibbs free energy, it is not at all depending upon the number of electrons present. It completely depends upon the concentration, or nothing but the equilibrium constant. This equilibrium constant is quite depending upon the concentration of Zn2 plus or Cu2 plus ions which you are using. So, a Gibbs free energy is directly proportional to, Gibbs free energy is equal to minus Rt ln Kc. Okay, so this is the equation which relates standard Gibbs free energy of an electrical work done in a given potential cell. Now, let us solve a problem using the Nernst equation. So now here they have given the question, if the cell reaction Ni of solid plus 2Ag plus with certain concentration gives Ni2 plus with 2Ag. So if the E standard electrode potential, standard potential of the cell is 1.05 volts, then what we have to do is we need to calculate the EMF of the cell. Now let us first write down the given data. So what is given? So first of all, they have given us concentration of Ag plus. Concentration of Ag plus is 0.002 molar concentration. Nickel 2 plus concentration is 0.160 molars. Okay. So now, further, observe over here, they have given 2 as the coefficient of Ag plus. Therefore, what you have to do is, in the calculation part, you need to take square of 0.002. That is because 2 moles of Ag plus is reacting, therefore it will be square of 0.002. So taking the square of this, that gives us 2 into 10 power minus 3, that is nothing but 4 into 10 power minus 6 molar concentration. Okay. So now, next further, the number of electrons involved in is equal to 2. We know temperature is 298 Kelvin. So the temperature reaches 298 Kelvin. Temperature is 298 Kelvin. Now what you have to do is you need to calculate the EMF of the cell, where the standard electrode potential of the cell, E naught of cell, is equal to 1.05 volts. So now let us write down the formula, that is E cell is equal to E naught of cell minus 0.059 divided by N log of. Now, which is the numerator, which is the denominator? If you observe carefully, nickel is getting oxidized to Ni2+. Therefore, the numerator should be concentration of Ni2+. And the denominator should be concentration of Ag+ the whole square. Okay, concentration of Ag+ the whole square. Substitute the values. So, E0 of the cell is 1.05 minus 0.059. divided by 2, that is the 2 number of electrons are reacting, log of 0.160 divided by 4 into 10 power minus 6. Okay, so 4 into 10 power minus 6, we need to substitute those values. So what we get is 1.05 minus, if you divide this value, you get 0.0295 into log of 0.04 into 10 power 6. So this will be the equation. Now once you do this, what you get is log of 0.04 into 6 into log of 10. If you split this particular equation, you get 1.05 minus 0.0295 into log of 0.04 into log of 0.04 into, sorry, plus log of 0.04 plus 10 to the power 6 can be written as 6 log 10. Log 10 is 1, so that it will be nothing but just 6. Okay, so log of 0.04. So if you have any doubt regarding how to calculate the logarithm value, I have uploaded the already uploaded a video regarding how to calculate logarithm and anti-logarithm values. You can go through that video. I'll provide the link in the description box. On clicking that link, you can open the, you can go through the calculation of log and anti-log from Clark's table. Okay, so once you find out the log of 0.04, you get the value 1.05 minus 0.0295 into minus 1.39 plus 6. Sorry, minus 1.39 plus 6, which is equal to 1.05 minus 0.0295 into 6 minus 1.39 is 4.61. Is 4.61. On substituting that value and on calculation, we will get the EMF of the cell that is equal to 0.91 volts. So this will be the EMF of the cell at this particular concentration. So this is how you calculate the EMF of the cell of if the variable concentration of the reactant and the products are given. Okay, the oxidation substance and the reducing substance concentration, if it is non-unity, then you can use this particular equation to calculate the EMF of the cell. Okay, I hope you have understood the concepts which I explained today. In the next class, we will be discussing more about this particular electrochemistry chapter. Thank you for watching.